Thank you and good night. I don't know how you follow that, really. Thank you to Mr. Rubino and the FMS. Great job. Probably going to use a little more cowbell. Welcome. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I'm going to bring up the class president, Mr. Jonathan Amron.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
God bless America.
Good evening. Ms. Gifford, Mr. Keough, staff, family, and friends, and especially the 8th grade class of 2017. I'd like to welcome all of you to our annual recognition ring ceremony. My name is James Adamo. I'm the 8th grade team coordinator, and I'd like to thank all of you for joining us this evening. A los hispanohablantes quiero decir bienvenidos a esta celebración en reconocimiento de nuestros estudiantes del octavo grado. Gracias por venir. I'm going to keep this Spanish portion of my remarks short because all of my 8th grade students are going to give a short speech for half of their final exam grade tonight. So everyone get comfortable. It's going to be a long night. You haven't lived until you've seen an auditorium full of people panic. Before we begin, I'd like to take a moment to thank a number of people who helped make this evening possible. Thank you, Mr. Theodo, for setting up our technical requirements. Our custodians for setting up our stage this evening. To the PTSA for generously donating the refreshments that will be served at tonight's, after tonight's ceremony. The PTSA among Maureen Carvalho for the lovely plants you see here on the stage. I'd like to thank the Hastings on Hudson Board of Education and SEPA for your support throughout the year. I'd also like to take a moment to acknowledge the hard work of our own grade eight executive board, a student leadership council who have had a say in school initiatives and who have helped to organize special events. Members include Spencer Prevelay, Chelsea Sandler, Kaylee Oppenheimer, Graham Rubio, Sophia Hayes, Tilly Zwern-Gibnish, and that's it. Thank you to Mr. Christopher Roll for acting as that group's advisor. A big thank you to all the staff here at FMS, especially the 8th grade team. 8th graders, I think, they deserve a big round of applause. Lastly, I'd like to thank all of you in our community for continually supporting us here in middle school. And now, I'd like to bring up a special musical group. My classroom is right next to the music room, so I get to hear them rehearse, and I really think you're in for a treat. Welcome again, Mr. Rubino, Kate Diem, Kate Jones, Jessica Higgins, Jonesy Roy, and Hazel Pachillo. Yeah.
Choices, of incredible courses to take. You will meet new and exciting teachers, and yet you'll be able to still stay in touch with this wonderful group of teachers. And the other thing that happens in high school that I've always thought was so special is that you're going to meet a lot of other students, probably who you didn't know or never really had a chance to get to know. And one of the things that happens in high school is that you become friends with people from all different years, so your whole friend group really increases. And it's something really to look forward to. So I wish you all, I bring you congratulations to sit and enjoy what's going to happen this evening. I apologize that I can't stay. I just found out this afternoon that I was going to be able to come and do this. And then you have a wonderful celebration to look forward to tonight. Have a great summer, and I know that Mr. A is going to welcome you with open arms into the high school. So, congratulations.
Thank you, Jody. Before beginning my remarks this evening, I'd like to ask that we reflect for a time to remember those who have been part of our community who are no longer with us, be they parents or relatives or friends or others that we hold dear. We remember them tonight and always. We think fondly of them and we profoundly thank them for their contributions to our lives and to our community. Let us take a moment to silently think of them and for each of us, in our own way, to share with them our sincere gratitude and love for what they have provided. Thank you. Welcome to Recognition Night 2017. It's a pleasure to be here with you this evening to honor our 8th grade students and to be able to share this event with families and friends. Each year on this evening, I share a few thoughts I hope in some small way will help to guide our 8th graders as they move toward the adventures awaiting them next year and throughout their lives. The task of crafting these messages is one I take seriously, as I should. This year's message is very simple, incredibly powerful, and can be summed up in one word, kindness. You'll have to indulge me for a time while I use as a vehicle for expressing my core beliefs about kindness someone who is very, very dear to me. My granddaughter is named Evelyn. We call her Evie. She was named after my mom, Eva. Evie turned 2 about a month ago. She fills up my heart in ways that are difficult to express and in ways that each parent here feels about their 8th grader. She's cherubic and beyond adorable. She's sweet and acutely impish in her behavior and immensely affectionate. She loves to make people laugh. Like her mom, my daughter Steffi, she's got hair that's intensely curly, though Steffi's is brown and Evie's has a bit of a reddish cast. And cursed as she is by the laws of genetics and the Kimber bloodlines, it should come as no shock to anyone who has seen me and sees me that by a wide margin, Evie is already trailing her peers in height. At this point in her brief life, life is nothing but fun and possibility. She's surrounded by loving and supportive people who adore her completely and who celebrate each of her small and not so small intellectual and physical achievements. Achievements that just days before any one of them had been just beyond her capabilities. When she uses a table to stand upright, we applaud. For Evie, life so far has been very, very good. And the people in her life have been very, very kind. Evie, like the world she's exposed to, is perfect. But I am a realist, as are the parents of our 8th graders, and I understand that perfect as she is, as Evie's world expands, her experiences will broaden, and the universe of people with whom she interacts will grow. As we all do, she will inevitably experience life's challenges, and will come into contact with other people, people who are less kind and less supportive of her.
people who are more focused on their own needs and desires. Things will change. While Evie's family now treasures the intense curls in her red hair, her peers may tease her over them. While her family sees in her small stature as part of her adorable charm, others may make fun of her for being the smallest in her class. And if she's fortunate to excel in a particular area, others may try to turn those gifts into liabilities. They may accuse her of being a textbook geek or nerd. They may deem her not worthy of sitting with them at lunch or being invited to birthday parties. It literally makes me weep when I think that this child, who is so loved and so adored and is to us so perfect, may and will face these challenges. Needless to say, we live in difficult times. For reasons beyond my abilities to comprehend or explain, it appears to have become more permissible these days for good people to engage in behaviors that were always on display, but were usually viewed with greater disdain and disapproval than they now seem to be. It seems to have become more okay among some to denigrate others, to treat them as lesser, or to outrightly exclude them or cause them physical harm for what they look like, what they believe in, where they're from, who they love, or because of the physical or intellectual challenges to which they're subject. In these times, it seems that celebrating our differences and accepting others with those differences is no longer one of the accepted higher goals of humanity. I cannot accept that. I cannot accept that as part of the world our eighth graders and my little Evie will be inheriting. I cannot accept that a we versus they world or a separate and unequal world are the right answers in these or any other times. I cannot accept that it's okay for any of us to ignore the basic rules of civility commonly accepted by our society by cutting corners and doing things as small or large as dropping litter on the street or abusing an animal. It's difficult to understand how good people permit the darker parts of their psyches to propel them into behaviors they know to be misguided and inappropriate and hurtful, or what enables those good people to suspend their understanding, even for a moment, that the behaviors in which they're engaging will have harmful impact on the quality of life others enjoy. And I also have to say for me, it's not okay for any of us to see those unkind behaviors committed by friends, family, or even strangers, and then say and do nothing. I say to our incredible eighth graders, who are but a small number of the countless individuals who will influence the shape of our world in the years to come, that you cannot stand by passively in those moments. It cannot be okay for any of us, including each of you, to look the other way and thereby tacitly approve of a world in which some of us take advantage of others or denigrate and abuse others because of perceived philosophical differences or a misguided perception of superiority. It's sometimes scary or intimidating to stand up to others and to call them out when they're being inappropriate or breaking the rules of a decent, kind society. Yes, it's undeniable that sometimes standing up for what's right or kind or civil and interceding on behalf of someone who's being victimized comes at a personal risk. And yet the people who stand up at difficult times for good and right and kindness are always remembered by others, and even sometimes by history, as courageous and inspiring heroes. I have been witness to many of our eighth graders here who have engaged in these acts of kindness throughout the years at Farragut. It is no irony that those who rule by fear and intimidation and those who abuse and treat others unkindly are in reality isolated from and disrespected by good people. So if my granddaughter were among those being recognized today and venturing into the high school, I have to ask, what would you do when she is met with adversity? What will you say when the person seated at your lunch table moves their binder in such a way that she cannot sit? What will you say if someone tells her that she's geeky or slow or bossy? I can only hope that someone good, whether it's one of Evie's classmates or an adult or someone in this audience, steps forward to intercede by shouting down those perpetrators, a small act of heroism. And I wish that type of support for each of our eighth graders throughout their lives, so that sensitivity and awareness come to prevail, and so the rules of kindness and generosity become the universal norm. And so I invite each of our eighth graders here tonight, in fact, I invite everyone in this room tonight, to be those heroes and the active crusaders doing the hard work necessary to foster a world of unbounded kindness. I so want for Evie and for each of you. Before I conclude this evening, I'd like to take a moment to thank the parents of our eighth grade students for everything that you do and have done to support Farragut Middle School and for what you do to encourage and motivate and support your children. You have been an invaluable resource to all that we are dedicated to here at Farragut. I wish you all a wonderful summer surrounded by love.
Every year, a student is chosen to speak on behalf of our eighth graders. Please welcome this year's student speaker, Mr. Graham Ruthier.
Others, but as we moved on and learned, we got better. We learn how to analyze situations, see good from bad, and how lucky we are that we've had people to help us on this journey. The title now begins to show itself as we begin to ponder our potential life paths. In sixth grade, we learned about writing structure, and we all had a wonderful time working on IV. The first big project of our lives. We all shared the stress of making sure our sources were highlighted with at least four different colors. We all had to complete our outlines, we all had to get our sources verified, and we all had to wait to see our project grades. Fun. This is where we begin to learn how to edit our story. In seventh grade, we all created a sustainable society in the Ecotopia Project. We learned how to weave bold ideas into our stories. We all had to figure out a sustainable solution to make a better Earth, the main setting of our stories. I say main because I can't guarantee that we'll figure out how to colonize planets, but fingers crossed. We all had to struggle to come up with our name for our projects. Some of the names we came up with included Ecofish. Ecofish. Saturn City, Sartopia, Mega, El Eco Aldia, to name a few. As you can see, we got very creative. This helped us learn how to keep readers interested in turning the pages of our books. In eighth grade is where our own characters began to truly show themselves. We all labored hard in our social studies classes to make as much money as we could in the stock market game. Some of us tried to work really hard investing stocks. Others found another way to make money, a way around how to work hard. They turned criminal. This was very successful in some cases, and in others they were caught almost instantly, but it made for great entertainment. This is where the protagonists and antagonists have started to reveal themselves. Now we are being set free into the unknown of high school, left to continue writing our books on our own, having more freedom than ever before, having more spelling errors than ever before, having to do more laundry than ever before, according to my mom. This causes the biggest cliffhanger. Can we do it? Do we know what the little symbols on the clothing tags mean? Does anyone? Anyone? The plot will thicken from here on in. The characters will begin to come more human. But we are now free to write what we want, say what we want, and tell our own story. We're moving up in the world! Mr. Kia knows a lot about that, former tech teacher turned vice principal. It's going to be scary, but we will persevere. Looking out into this crowd, it's funny how much we've changed. There's some obvious changes, height, looks and voices, and some non-obvious ones. Our ideas, our hopes, and our dreams. We came here as fifth graders, the youngest of the middle schoolers. Now we're on top, the oldest of the bunch. It feels good, doesn't it? Well, next year as we move to high school, we will be back on the bottom. Damn. It's a vicious cycle. Once we like where we are, get comfortable and confident in how we feel, we get thrown into a more complex situation. But hey, that's what makes us learn. And it keeps the story interesting, because as we all know, conflict drives thought. I don't normally speak on behalf of the entire eighth grade, but when I do, it's to say thanks. Stay thankful, my friends. We as an eighth grade would like to say thanks just one more time. Thanks to our teachers, friends, family, and loved ones. Thanks. And Miss Kipper, don't think I forgot about you. I know you're going to miss us, and thanks for supporting us all the way through. Hopefully, we will return over the years to let you know how our stories have continued. Even though the middle school chapter of our lives is ending, the high school chapter is just beginning. And I cannot wait to see how that chapter ends. I know that sounds cheesy, but many endings are. Although a cheesy ending is sometimes real gouda.
About school being like a book, can't use that. Gouda joke, nope. Thanks, Graham. Great job. At this time, I would like to bring up the 7th and 8th grade chorus led by Mr. Jonathan Riss. Marine Order of the Sky. This time, we will present the Farragut Middle School Student Awards. A detailed description of these awards appears on the back of your program. Please welcome back to the stage, Mr. Jonathan Riss, to present the River Arts Council Christine Nelson Memorial Scholarship Award.
Recipient of the River Arts Council Christine Nelson Award is deeply committed and involved in music education and is selected based on exceptional music talent and a strong desire to continue music study. The recipient of the award is selected unanimously by the middle school music department and receives a scholarship to further individual music training. The recipient this year has enriched curricular performing ensembles, extracurricular performing ensembles, and even academic music classes simply by leading by example. The example this student sets on a consistent basis is one of dedication, diligence, and exemplary musicianship. While adjudication festivals are never the end-all, be-all assessment of musical quality, and high school students in the audience take note of that, I would be remiss if I didn't note the fact that at the annual New York State School Music Association Solo and Ensemble Festival, this student has performed level 6 solos, the highest degree of difficulty, and 3 years in a row, 6th through 8th grade, earned ratings of 99 or 100. On behalf of the music department faculty, I take great pleasure in announcing that this year's recipient of River Arts Council Christine Nelson Memorial Scholarship is Bebe Seidenberg.
Please welcome Mrs. Sue Horowitz, who will present the Delta Kappa Gamma Award.
The Delta Kappa Gamma Award recognizes a student who has demonstrated personal growth and academic achievement through hard work and commitment. This year, it's my pleasure to give this award to Sophia Gunther.
Please welcome Savoy Kokin, presenting the Skylar Sontancredi Memorial Award. She is Skylar's cousin.
Hello, my name is Savoy Kokin and I'm Skylar's cousin. Before I start the awards, I would just like everyone to give a huge round of applause for the Farragut Bell School Class of 2017. From giving me piggyback rides in my grandma's pool to anything else we did together, he always made every moment extremely enjoyable. He lit up every room he walked into. I am presenting this award in memory of my cousin Skylar Sontancredi. This award recognizes two student athletes who each demonstrated a love of the game. As evidenced by exceptional ability and sportsmanship, unbridled energy and the ability to motivate teammates, these are just some of the multiple qualities which made Skylar a unique athlete and such a special person. I'm honored to announce and distribute the Skylar Award 2017 to my friends Chloe Carvalho and Bryce Jacobs.
Join me in welcoming Ms. Lisa Littman to speak a little bit about the PTSA Scholarship Awards.
Hi, everybody. Let me just start by saying on behalf of the PTSA, congratulations to the 8th graders for all you've accomplished. So I'm here to explain on behalf of the PTSA why the PTSA is here tonight. Some of you with older children might be saying, I don't remember the PPSA being at 8th grade recognition night before. And the answer is, we haven't. You see us at high school graduation at senior awards night because we hand out scholarships each year to our graduating seniors. We give about 5 or 6 scholarships in the hope of trying to offset even just a tiny bit the huge cost of college. So this year, we had a discussion and we said, you know, we honor the hard work of our high school seniors. Why don't we honor the hard work of our 8th graders as well? So our Farragut vice presidents met with Mrs. Kipper and floated the idea to her about honoring our 8th graders, and she was thrilled and incredibly appreciative. We then talked amongst the faculty and the administrators to decide on different categories to honor that haven't been honored before, and came up with 3 categories: art, leadership, and foreign language. So in a moment, I'll turn this over to the presenters for those awards. But I just want to say one more time, well, actually I'll say it for the first time, that we also want to thank you, families and community, for all your support of the PTSA. Without you, we could never do what we do. And one more time, congratulations, students, and congratulations, families.
Los siguientes premios son para 2 estudiantes que han mostrado excelencia en el campo de lenguajes, específicamente en el español. Estos 2 recipientes se esfuerzan por alcanzar el éxito. Tienen una hambre para aprender y la curiosidad necesaria para lograr la maestría del idioma. Un idioma te pone en un vacío durante toda la vida. 2 idiomas te abran todas las puertas a lo largo del camino. Hay muchas puertas que están abiertas para estos 2 estudiantes. Felicitaciones. Congratulations to Maren Diz and Adam Oppenheimer. French speakers. I prepared some remarks using all the French that I know for this year's Excellence in French Awards. Bonjour. Bonsoir. Je m'appelle Monsieur Damo. Comment tu t'appelles? Je suis fatigué. Et toi? Le temps, il fait croissant, fromage, merci. These 2 students have shown excellent effort and participation in French class. They've strived to improve their language skills each and every day. They practice speaking with classmates, friends, and family members. These students have succeeded in all aspects of their language study and have shown great interest in traveling to different Francophone countries. They also speak much better French than I do. Congratulations to Dahlia Seidel and Julia Gardner. Excellence in art, please welcome Mr. Ezra Elliott.
excellence in art awards have shown a variety of artistic abilities. They are masterful in a variety of mediums and techniques, equally adept with paint, pencil, clay, and collage. They are devoted to their craft, working tirelessly to ensure their pieces fulfill their vision. But most of all, they are daring risk takers, using their most powerful art-making tool, their minds, to invent and create artwork that is both visually stunning and thought-provoking. Congratulations to Kayla Austin, Jasper Lincoln, and Emma Rubinowitz.
To announce the awards for excellence or outstanding leadership, please welcome our new assistant principal, Mr. Christopher Dio.
Represents. A young woman contacted me on Facebook. She told me that she had lived in Hastings at the time we moved here in 1975 and left less than 2 years after our arrival. She wanted to know if I was Lisa's mom. She then sent me the following message about Lisa. I was always a little shy and wary of strangers, and it was Lisa who initiated the friendship. I remember her as friendly, outgoing, and fun to be with. Because I was in the lower grade, I wasn't in the same classes. But whenever I saw Lisa in the halls in school, she was surrounded by lots of friends and usually laughing. She always stopped to say hello and give me a big smile. That someone would remember Lisa after knowing her for such a short time, more than 35 years ago, is a tribute to Lisa and to all of those who have received this award in the last 38 years. Having said all that, I am honored to present the 2017 Lisa Kaiser Award to Chelsea Seidel.
Mr. Marcus Skelton is last year's recipient of the NEXT Award. Marcus, are you here tonight? He's here tonight to announce this year's winner of the Student of the Year Award.
The recipient of this award has earned the highest grade point average for his or her years in middle school. This award is based solely on the recipient's final academic standing at the end of eighth grade. The award is provided by the Hastings Teachers Association. This year's recipients of the Student of the Year Award are Bryce Jacobs and Ben McDermott.
To assist in recognizing this year's graduating class.
I'm
Tomasi. Rory Connaughton. Marcus Okito. Carson Cunningham. Melanie Bailey. Rico Giovella. Marin Diz. Aiden Dowling. Jasper Lincoln. Devin Roper. Sergio Manero. Sarah McCullough. Isaac Marico. Bennett McDermott.
Olivia Santo.
Kelsey Sangano. Dahlia Sangano. Phoebe Seidenberg.
Thank you. I'm not afraid to die.
announcements in reference to the student party. Students must cross Farragut Ave with a crossing guard. I believe the police are at the Five Corners. The party will end at 11 p.m. If you will, after this ceremony, please meet out in the lobby where there are refreshments courtesy of the PTSA and Ms. Kipper. I'd like the graduating class to stand, please. Ladies and gentlemen, Hastings High School class of 2021. Thank you.